Something stirs within the shadows across Middle-earth. Eyes watch patiently with foul intent from hidden spaces. Mouths whisper from darkness to corrupt the minds of the just. Hands reach with greedy fingers from unwatched places to grasp for power and wealth. Who will raise their own light against the spread of this darkness? Who will stand against the unknown danger that creeps ever closer? To where shall we look for heroes?
Bilbo waved to the Beorning guards as he passed into the twilight landscape beyond the gate. A sickle moon was rising, and calm winds moved the grasses. Glóin was to have greeted them at Beorn's hall, but the old dwarf had not yet arrived. He'd wished to accompany them on their journey through Mirkwood to Erebor. Despite weary feet and a full stomach, Bilbo was in need of an evening stroll, to sing and to think, and hoped to be the first to greet Glóin on the road. Nori and Bomba were happy to sip the famous mead of the House of Beorn, especially Bomba. In the quiet way of hobbits, Bilbo moved invisibly through the night. Memories and thoughts of distant friends lay heavy on his heart that evening. The secret longing, the deep, dull ache that would never entirely abate, had grown stronger in recent days.
Honey looks delicious. I'll just have some. I can almost taste it! Stars! lazy lob! Ow! That hurt! I'm starting to regret taking that honey.
Impatient to greet his old friend Glowin, who was expected on the Old Forest Road, Bilbo left Bjorn's hall to wander the approaches of Mirkwood. After raiding a bee's hive for an after-dinner snack, he continued onward, eyes scanning the path ahead for the face of his old friend. Bilbo was so eager to see Glowin that he lost track of time, and soon the light began to dim. With the setting sun, the sounds of the Wilderlands came alive, with the clicks, calls, and squawks of creatures more attuned to nocturnal activity. Too late, Bilbo noticed the impending shroud of darkness.
Oh, my stars!
He exclaimed.
I seem to have gotten all turned around!
Suddenly, there was a snapping sound from the trees nearest Bilbo. He froze, staring at the tree nervously. But a soothing voice spoke softly from behind Bilbo.
Greetings, friend of the elves.
Much to Bilbo's relief, it was Arwen of Rivendell, accompanied by a tall woodland elf.
I am Legolas, son of Thranduil, whom you know well.
I will gladly accept assistance from the elves.
It is fortunate that we found you, elf friend.
Neither the folk of Rivendell nor of Thranduil's hall shall fail you.
My old friend Glowin awaits me on the Old Forest Road. Will you kindly assist me in finding the trail?
You have certainly gotten yourself lost, little friend.
Hold fast. I fear we are not alone. We must find a path past these creatures. foul creatures!
I have some healing art, should there be need.
We must weigh our options carefully.
We have friends in this forest.
My eyes see everything.
Like old times.
This forest is alive with vermin.
A red sun rises!
Let us pause and consider our next step.
I shall tend to the wounded.
stinging.
A red sun rises. Before your stroke fell.
Welcome to Rivendell.
The old forest road is no longer safe. I must warn Glowin.
I sense something strange has befallen Mirkwood.
Legolas observed. A silence descended upon the forest. Arwen agreed, adding,
Let us continue along the path, but remain vigilant should these creatures return.
Bilbo sensed something as well. An increasing feeling of being watched, of an unknown observer lurking nearby.
I feel the eyes of the forest on me,
he whispered. Arwen and Legolas glanced at each other in worry, for they had sensed this for some time now. Alas, before they could do anything about it, more spiders dropped from hidden webs above to attack.
More of the foul beasts descend!
Beware that creature. I mark it to be greater than its brethren.
The hidden arrow strikes first.
Vanquished the beasts. Come, my friends. I see the path ahead.
For days, a strange pull had drawn the creature towards the forest edge. Desire drove it on. The creature missed the cool air and precious darkness under stone. Yet for years it had roamed the wilderland, faithfully searching, hunting, craving. A nearby noise attracted its attention, and the creature slid through the branches to investigate. As it peered out of the trees onto a small trail, its ancient heart began to beat rapidly. For there it stood, the thief, the forever cursed. Finally, Baggins.
Having dispatched the spiders, Arwen and Legolas led Bilbo back to the Old Forest Road.
"I thank you, my friends, for rescuing a lost old hobbit," he said.
"What's this talk of being lost?"
called a voice from up the trail.
"Glowin!"
Bilbo cried with joy, for it was he at last.
"Hello, my old friend!"
Glowin gestured to the stout companion at his side.
"This is my son, Gimli, who has traveled with me from the lonely mountain."
The younger dwarf nodded to Bilbo, but eyed the elves warily.
"Well met,"
came his gruff response. Arwen nodded in respect to both dwarves.
"With Bilbo in the charge of these strong companions, we shall take our leave. We have business elsewhere, and a meeting of our own to keep."
Bilbo was sad to see the elves go, as he much liked their presence. But he was eager to relive old tales over food and drink with Glowin at Bjorn's warm hearth. The elves departed silently into the woods, while Bilbo and the dwarves made down the forest path.
"Oh, the trees of Mirkwood bring back memories of my younger days."
"I'll be glad to join the feast at Bjorn's hall. I look forward to meeting Bjorn himself." "Snakes block our path! I thought this road was safe."
"No longer, I'm afraid." "We will face them together, old friend."
Thank you.
you will not harm my father and live, beast!
Friend elf.
Thank you.
Thank you.
my journeys bring me hither. Gah!
I bring news from Rivendell.
When will the day come of our revenge?
The water's on the beach to the weary.
My old days as a burglar.
creature hesitated. It would have struck without mercy, had not that filthy dwarf been with Baggins. The creature feared the strength of dwarves. Fortunately, it knew of a safer way to snare its prey. For the creature had made friends in the forest over the years. It had learned their chittering tongue, and they'd helped each other in dark deeds. Noiselessly, under shadowed boughs, the creature slid off to plead with the lady of the nearby wood. Tasty flesh it would offer her. For himself, the creature desired only a tiny thing. A trinket, the smallest of things.
Fighting shoulder to shoulder with dwarves brought a familiar stirring to Bilbo's heart. He paused, remembering times and companions who were now only a memory. He sighed, breaking his own reverie. Suddenly and silently, Arwen strode onto the path. Behind her was another elf who Bilbo had not met before. The way they appeared suddenly unnerved Bilbo, but if the dwarves had any reaction, they kept it to themselves.
"Greetings, friends,"
she said.
"This is Rossiel of the Woodland Realm."
"What happened to Legolas?"
asked Bilbo. Arwen smiled, nodding her head.
"The forest path has become unsafe. He carries word of this back to the Elven King."
"We must make our way to Bjorn's Hall and report the same,"
Glowin added.
"Let us make haste."
Bilbo went to take up his pack, only to discover that it was missing.
Stars! I've misplaced my pack! And my sword as well! I must find them!
He fumbled subconsciously for the ring that he once wore around his neck, but was no longer there.
Bilbo's sting is a mighty weapon!
Glowin roared.
We must recover it. Let us search back along the trail.
Master Glowin is correct,
Arwen said, then paused to look from Bilbo to the dwarves.
And speed is of the utmost importance, but Rosiel knows these woods best, and she and I are blessed with the eyes of the elves. We will find the sword and pack.
I will not leave these woods without Sting!
Bilbo exclaimed in an urgent whisper, so as to not draw the attention of any nearby creatures.
And I will not abandon Bilbo,
Glowin added. Taken aback, Arwen offered a compromise.
Rosiel and I will take up this task with Bilbo, but brave dwarf, I request most humbly as Lady of Rivendell that you first carry word to Bjorn and then return.
Glowin grumbled to himself a moment. Though not pleased, he understood the import of her request.
I will do as you ask. Reluctantly.
Arwen bowed in thanks to the dwarves, and with Rosiel, made off with Bilbo.
I take comfort in your companionship, friend elves.
It is an honor to accompany the great Bilbo Baggins of the Shire. Let us hurry to find your lost blade, then return you to the safety of Bjorn's Hall.
takes me back to my old days as a burglar. Stinging.
If you don't keep your feet, no telling where you might be swept off to. Shortcuts make delays, but ins make longer ones.
My old days as a burglar. Thank you.
Sensing the imminent arrival of yet more spiders, Arwen stood closer to Bilbo. A click, click, clicking echoed in the darkness, indicating many legs and mandibles approaching. She worried that she and Rossiel could not alone provide the protection they had promised if they tarried much longer.
"I fear that we may not locate your pack, friend Hobbit,"
she whispered.
"Perhaps it is time we retired to the safety of Bjorn's Hall for the night. We can resume our search tomorrow in the light of day."
Spiders closed in all around, some skittering along the leaf-strewn forest floor, while others dropped from the gnarled branches above. At the edge of their vision, a great spider menaced them, much larger than the rest. Was it directing the others? If so, for what purpose? Bilbo swallowed hard, feeling fear, despite the reassurance he felt from his companions.
"I think you are correct,"
he chuckled, a forced mirth he did not feel.
Let us depart this place presently."
"We have not been
idle. Bilbo. These spiders are in a contentious mood."
"Takes me back to my old days as a burglar."
"The enemy is upon us." The enemy is upon us.
For Rivendell!
Well.
Bilbo! No!
The onslaught of the spiders finally paused, but only for a moment, as they sought to regroup. In the confusion of the melee, the companions had become separated, though each was fully aware of the calamity of Bilbo's capture. The spiders seemed to coordinate their attack with a purpose, and the abduction of Bilbo was not mere happenstance. They must have wanted the aging hobbit for some purpose only they could understand. Dark as this event was, there was one glimmer of hope in that they clearly wanted him alive, and that meant he could be rescued. If only the companions could gather again at Bjorn's Hall and then stage a rescue. But the lull in the battle was over, and the spiders were gathering once again in greater numbers. The first task was simply survival. Only then could a rescue be attempted. Welcome to the deck building tutorial. Here, we'll walk you through the basics of creating an effective deck for play. In the process, you'll be able to create a unique deck and save it for use later. Let's get started.
I shall claim full amends for every fall and stubbed toe.
Give me adventure over respectability any day.
Thank you.
You've learned much during these prelude quests so far. In the next quest, Flight Through Darkness, you can enjoy the standard quest experience for the first time. Each quest has three playstyles to choose from. Each style determines overall difficulty and features different styles of play. The first time you play Flight Through Darkness, you'll be restricted to narrative playstyle. After that, you can pick the playstyle you enjoy best. We recommend trying each style to see which suits you best. The different playstyles are narrative, for casual players who want to enjoy each story at a lower difficulty level. In a narrative game, during upkeep, you gain 3 resources and draw 2 cards per round, while Sauron gains 3 resources and draws a full hand. Adventure. This style offers more difficulty, with an even combat balance. In an adventure game, during upkeep, you gain 3 resources and draw 1 card per round, while Sauron gains 4 resources and draws a full hand. Challenge. For players who feel they know the game inside and out and wish to prove their skills. In a challenge game, during upkeep, you gain 3 resources and draw 1 card per round, while Sauron gains 5 resources and draws a full hand. In addition to selecting your playstyle, you'll also get to choose which deck you will use on your quest. Simply select the current deck in order to examine its contents, or choose a different deck. Make sure to choose carefully, as the right mix of heroes and cards can greatly increase your chance of success. Likewise, a bad interaction between heroes in your deck might lead to ruin. If you decide that none of your current decks meets your expectations, you can return to the decks menu at any time to edit an existing deck or construct an all-new deck. Good luck, and may fortune smile upon your fellowships as they stand against the forces of Sauron. The festive mood in Bjorn's hall is broken when Glowin and Gimli burst in. At first, the celebrants laugh at the news that Bilbo has lost his pack, but sober up when Glowin growls,
"There's nothing funny about spiders on the move in Mirkwood!"
As Glowin departs to rejoin his friend, some revelers share a look. He's right. A threat from Mirkwood isn't to be taken lightly. The adventurers agree to lend their aid, but by the time they gather, the impatient old dwarf has already departed. Undeterred, the fellowship heads up the old forest road. Precious minutes pass with no sign of any disturbance. Then, as doubts begin to creep in, the sounds of violence just off the trail. Rushing forward, the adventurers see a mass of spiders close in on Glowin, who shouts to you that Bilbo is taken. The spiders of Mirkwood seem driven onward by some dark intelligence. Alas, what began as an attempt to aid Bilbo is now a fight for survival.
I am Aragorn, son of Arathorn.
Mine is the choice of Lúthien.
I will go and look on the halls of Durin.
We do not escape the shadows of these times.
Rivendell!
He looks more like a grocer than a burglar.
Welcome to Rivendell.
With the threat of the spiders momentarily abated, you stopped to catch your breath. When you entered the woods, you had no clear plan. And with the news of Bilbo's abduction, it is clear that you should now return to the hall and organize a proper expedition before attempting a rescue. You prepare to embark on this course of action when you hear the nearby howl of wolves. First spiders, and now wolves, as the whole of Mirkwood risen up against you. Running down the old forest road simply won't do. You decide your best chance is to find a path straight through the woods. Running through the darkness, you leave the wolves behind while navigating the maze of branches, roots, and leaves. Before long, you're hopelessly lost. And soon after, you hear the now familiar sounds of chitinous creatures dropping from the trees to surround you. You evaded the wolves, only to stumble into a den of more spiders.
Farewell.
He cannot stand alone.
Welcome to Rivendell.
Trampling through the woods grows increasingly difficult. You feel confident that you are heading in the general direction of Bjorn's hall, but without landmarks or the stars to guide you in the thick of the forest, you begin to doubt your senses. Making your way forward as carefully as possible, the woods around you become eerily silent. You ease into a small clearing, filled with the debris of a hastily abandoned camp. Before you can make even a cursory examination, you hear the approaching sound of something. Is it more wolves? More spiders? Or something worse?
To the abyss.
You evade the pursuing pack and can soon make out the lights of Bjorn's Hall in the distance. Your sense of danger ebbs for the moment, with thoughts of food, drink, and a warm fire sustaining you as you plan a proper rescue of Bilbo. You discover that layers of webs bar your way forward as you hear the now familiar noise of encroaching spiders, along with a new sound, the onrush of many tiny wings and the screech of bats. First spiders and now bats. A fat spider drops down in front of the wall of webs, challenging your progress as the cacophonous mass of bats draws near. If that wasn't enough, you hear the distant sound of wolves. Truly, Mirkwood is filled with dangers this night.
Yeah. Never underestimate the strength of a dwarf.
He cannot stand alone! He cannot stand alone!
Ah!
Having fought through the onslaught of the creatures of Mirkwood, you and your companions have returned to the comfort of Bjorn's Hall. Though you survived your ordeal, Bilbo remains missing. The time has come to gather a fellowship and re-enter the forest to rescue the old hobbit. This concludes the Prelude campaign. Armed with a good understanding of gameplay, you can now quest forth across Middle-earth in confidence. If you remain unsure about anything, worry not. You can replay any of the individual tutorial quests at any time to refresh your memory. We encourage you to replay this or future quests with different fellowships and card deck combinations. With practice comes skill and additional rewards, which you may use to unlock new cards or cosmetic items such as card backs, avatars, or player frames. Go forth and farewell.